हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। क्लास 9 सब्जेक्ट आईटी अंडर द एनएसक्यू स्कीम पार्ट बी। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट अवर चैप्टर वर्ड प्रोसेसिंग बेसिक। अवर टॉपिक इज एडिंग शेडिंग टू पेजेस एंड पैराग्राफ और टेक्स्ट, एडजस्टिंग मार्जिन एंड ओरिएंटेशन, reviewing a document, aligning text and using tabs. So these are our topics which I will discuss. So first thing is adding shading to pages, paragraph or text. Suppose you already type a single word, you can also give the border and you can also give the shading. Suppose you already type 4 to 5 line a single paragraph, so you can also perform bordering and shading to the surrounding the paragraph, and you can in larger way you can also give border and shading to our page. So minimum thing is text with single words, a paragraph or a page. Okay, so we can also give border and with shading also. So apart from the border, we can also add colors or grayscale patterns over a paragraph or text to catch the attention of people. To apply setting, click the home tab. This option you will keep in the mind, and select border, and then select border and shading. Then shading tab, you can see fill box and style box. Okay, fill box you can set the color, style box you can set the shading percentage. Okay, if you don't want to shading, you can also cancel this. To remove shading, click the no color option in the shading drop down menu. Okay, so we can also cancel this. Okay, now if you want to print your document, so first before printing we must set page set. So according to page set we must set the margin. Okay, margin means topmost portion, bottommost, leftmost and rightmost, means this place always blank. Okay, so for this purpose, open the document, click the page layout tab. You can see the margin drop down arrow in the page setup box. Then a drop down list you can see for predefined margin appears, means some standard already appears, so it will help you. You can directly select and this standard margin automatically apply on your current document, working document. So in this you don't need to specify any margin values. Select the required margin option, the change will be applied immediately. Okay, now you can also change the page orientation. Page orientation means you can, suppose you have a letter or application, so you generally you can print in vertical form, means portrait form. Suppose you have an attendance sheet, okay, or a certificate of any person. So this data will print on landscape style, means horizontally we can set the page and then we can print this. So adjusting page orientation and previewing a document. Open the document, click the page layout tab, drop down arrow of orientation in a page setup group, select the portrait or landscape option, means portrait means we can see the page will see in vertical style, landscape means page we can see in horizontal form. The changes will be applied immediately. Suppose you want to before printing you want to see how looks when we will print on paper, so you can see in advance. Okay, this is called a to preview. To preview the document, click on the file, then select print. If you want to come out the section, if you want to cancel or you want to again type your work and start your work, you can escape to cancel the print preview action. Now our last topic is tabs, aligning text using tabs. So tabs are the good for indentation because their width can be adjusted according to preference. Okay, so we can say again, on the keyboard you can see the tab key. Okay, when you press tab key, always half inch our cursor jump. Okay, so when you use tab key, Using the tape key, we can arrange our data in tabular style. Okay, we have already had table option, but another way we can set our data using the tape key option. So by default, every time you press tape key, the insertion point means our cursor will move half inch to the right. Okay, in word processing application, there are five kinds of tabs stored in Word. Okay, you can see left tab, center tab, right tab, decimal tab and bar tab. Okay, so decimal tab stop align numbers around a decimal point, and a bar tab stop does not text, it insert a vertical bar at the insertion point. Means decimal tab, suppose you have some values, in values decimal point you will use. So one value decimal, then second value decimal point, the third value decimal point, it must be in line of series. So decimal tab. But bar tab will create a column line between two series. Okay, so it will generate a vertical line between two column of data. So it looks like a table. Okay, now aligning text using tabs continue. We can set this tab using another thing. We can now, what is a tab? But now I want to practically want to use. So we can set this tab using horizontal ruler or paragraph dialog box. So you can see in our Word document, a ruler means a scale type option you can see in our Word document. So with the help of ruler, we can create tab stop position. Okay, so, or another option we can perform using paragraph dialog box. Okay, if you don't see the horizontal ruler that runs along at the top of the document, so click the view tab and ruler. Okay, setting tabs by using paragraph dialog box are as follow. Okay, so this thing you can set on the directly click on ruler. Okay, when you mouse click and click on the ruler, so it will create left, right, center according to our choice. Another thing, the same thing we can perform using paragraph dialog box. It also responsible to set the tab stop position. So for this purpose, we can open our document, page layout, dialog launcher arrow of the paragraph group. You can see a small arrow, paragraph dialog box, then we can use tabs, and then you can select left, center or right, tab stored position, then set and add more tabs. You can further one by one you can decide your tab, and then finally you can click on the OK. So all tab stay position will appear on the ruler. Then you can use tab key and start your typing your data in a tabular style format, line by line. Okay students, today this chapter our complete has completed. So thanks for attending the online class. You can see the below comment box. You must type your name and class with section and following question answers. So today my question is, how to add a shading to a paragraph? My second question is, what is a tab? Write all types of tab names. Last question, how to set page orientation of a page? Mention only steps. After writing above answer in comment box and then type your question, your doubt also. So definitely I will reply. Okay, thank you students.